It has been said that film is more than a device to create a mood and tell a story. In Richard Lester's work, this becomes more than evident. Lester is one of a new group of directors who use film to jolt us out of our customary frame of life.
Berkey rode in, down and needed, Nancy greeted, Berkey rode in.
Petulia, his new motion picture, is an uncommon movie. If you're like most and get with it pretty quickly, you will have a lot to talk about afterwards. He has chosen San Francisco as the background, a positive town where the images are forceful and an enormously attractive place for his people to shoot in. Come with Richard Lester as he takes you into the world of Petulia, a world filled with excitement, inspiration, and unexpected surprises. Richard Lester carefully selects his locations for realism, detail, and atmosphere. To achieve this, he spends 7 consecutive nights in the lobby of the Fairmount Hotel, shooting from midnight to dawn, the beginning of a wild, unpredictable relationship. His zeal for the unique extends to his selection of performers and is no more apparent than in his choosing Academy Award winner Julie Christie and George C. Scott for the leading roles in this Warner Brothers Seven Arts production.
I must say that from the beginning of reading the first screenplay, I could only see Julie Christie. I've never thought of the character being played by anyone else at all. I think she's in many ways like the character she's playing, and I don't mean that unkindly. If I give a little description of the character, she is a person who is always expected to receive 100% from life, a person who demands 100%, who demands the earth to shake with every relationship, and who is having a sort of 60% relationship with her husband.
Playing the part of Julie's hollow husband and co-starring in Petulia with a new image is Richard Chamberlain. Richard Lester is not specific on how he shoots a film, but he is on who he works with.
I'm enormously selective about cameramen. We have a common language, and I think he views the film not only from a photographic point of view, but from the point of view of what he can do in every scene to make the film work.
Roll camera, action.
You're an official host.
Oh.
That's my husband over there.
Uh-huh.
I've been married 6 months and I've never had an affair.
Lester's very approach to the story of Petulia is provocative. He starts it in the middle and moves toward its end and its beginning at the same time.
My name is Petulia.
I'm not surprised.
Polo is your wife?
My ex-wife. Good night.
Richard Lester prefers to film all of his story in locales that give a meaning to what is happening in a scene.
The film is a tragedy of communication in love and the inability of people to commit not only to each other in this personal relationship, but into problems of the world around them, to deal with the problems of violence, the problems of warfare, the problems of religion that were going on in America. And I hope that's apparent.
Got that, Basher.
The film's producer waited for several years until Lester was finished with other commitments.
I was sent the first draft screenplay of it by Ray Wagner, and then I spoke to him on the phone, then spoke to Julie, and we went on from there.
Action. Need any help?
Oh, here. No, have some. I love you.
I think it had to be made in America. I think the characters, or the feeling I wanted to get into it, was specifically American. Also, I think that these people would live in San Francisco.
Give me it back.
Come on.
This you
paid
for.
Look, I brought... Cut it out, stupid! You're gonna pay for
it! Give me my sardines!
I don't have any set rules in dealing with actors or actresses. You have to get to know each person separately. You can't deal with Sir Laurence Olivier the way you would deal with Ringo. You try to find out a means of communication so that you can express yourself, perhaps clumsily, and perhaps only physically.
As a director, Richard Lester surrounds himself with several key technicians, but the prime responsibility and decisions are his.
I like to feel that I know all the members of the crew. I would much rather shoot a film with 15 of my friends than with 75 of my enemies, and then work with them, doing their jobs with them, and all sort of muck in together.
Lester and the Warner Brothers Seven Arts Company create a setting in a private home in the suburbs of San Francisco to stage a highly dramatic scene.
You told the policeman you had a dizzy spell?
Right. I fell on my bottom.
You were beaten up. You were somebody's punching bag.
I won't have you cross-examine this girl.
Your son almost killed this girl.
Hey, listen, Doc, I'll sit still for only so much. Well, it's none of your business. My boy was in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, looking at boats.
When Dad called, I was having dinner with some cousins of mine. Good, mouth-watering, old-fashioned Creole cooking.
All right, Archie. Everybody gets dizzy spells.
Archie is a moderately successful surgeon, and one day meets Petulia, and he begins to feel, having met her, having tasted the sort of excitement of 100% living, that he would never be satisfied without it. And so he becomes absolutely desperate, unable to commit and say, I'm going to make this decision in a relaxed manner. He becomes her and is left searching for the 100%, waiting for the earth to shake.
I don't know what Dick is doing, but I'm convinced that he knows what he's doing. Very interesting man to work for.
Cut.
One of the things I think that is most exciting in filmmaking is to watch an interesting and exciting performance through the lens and seeing what is coming through, what is being recorded on film. The more involved you are in that physically, I think the more exciting it becomes and the closer you are to finding out whether you've got what you want.
Dick Lester directs a motion picture three times, once in the writing, once on the set, and once in the editing room. As he does, he projects an image to people he works with as a nonconformist, an imaginative director.
Dick is an intelligent, sensitive, terribly clever man.
He works very unrestrictedly. You discover what he's about, then the next thing you have to do is just discover what's in his mind. You know, once you've got a clue about that, then you're sort of free to do anything.
In this motel setting, Lester takes a jab at the over-automated society of today.
Hand down.
Action.
Evening. We've got an elevator, but it's only for going for the paper and the like. I mean, if you don't want to use your car. But you'll have to use the ramp because of the key. The key lets you know when you get to your room.
I have a mind like a butterfly. I work in a haphazard, sloppy fashion. I like to think of myself as a benevolent dictator, but I'm sure other people would question it. I'm certainly a dilettante. I'm a bad chess player, a bad organizer, and I think I probably make the world's most expensive home movies.
Okay, everybody, hold it down. Roll camera. Scene 455, take one.
Action.
Get back in time, you can still pick the winning ticket and make somebody happy.
I'm going to marry you, Archie.
It's the Pepsi generation.
Hey, can you direct us to a Chinese restaurant?
Richard Lester is leaving his stamp on San Francisco and on Petulia. He does it with an exciting style and pace. Richard Lester makes it that way.